Today, we're taking on the Diablo Immortal
Wheel of Pain.
And every time I die in game like this,
you only get one freebie out of me.
The death counter goes up.
I have to spin the Wheel of Pain.
And every time I spin, I have to spend a lot of money. The game gets harder or I have to grind a lot. So thank you to Diablo Immortal for sponsoring this video.
And first up, a $500 Team Seas donation already.
All right, there we go. The donation is done.
$500 are spent already.
So hopefully we don't die for a while now, but Diablo Immortal is Blizzard's largest Diablo game to launch to date.
This game has an extensive storyline, crazy characters and abilities. Just look at all of this stuff. I'm using the Necromancer right now, and I'm actually kind of scared of this dude right here. Let's go get out of here.
But yeah, you can play by yourself or you can play with the party. Today I'm gonna be playing by myself to make it very challenging and to make it even harder. You see these little red potions up right here? Those heal me. That is the only potion I'm ever going to be able to use today, which means I'm going to die a lot more. But not to that guy. Get out of here and get, look at this chest we got. We love the chests. Give me all the rewards, dude. We love them. Yum. But the game is on a huge shared world with other players where you can do what you want, or you can follow the extensive campaign, which we're going to do right now
after we beat this tree.
And hopefully don't die. Oh my gosh, that was a lot of damage. Another rule that I have to make this harder, I cannot run away from any creatures or things that I find. I have to fight them till the death. Basically, the odds are in your favor to see more deaths. Okay? Like, look at all this. But we're too strong. Get out of here.
Hello. How are you?
Look at this. Look at this. Okay, after we take all these out, just, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I was literally just about to make a joke about how that guy died. And I was like, look at him. He probably had to spin the wheel. But we actually died.
On to spin number two. Oh my gosh,
no,
dude.
God.
Carla.
Hi.
Here's my phone. Beat whatever you want.
I was busy, okay, I swear.
Thank you for the resurrection, sir. Still counts as a death for me, though.
Oh my gosh, this is so swag.
Give me all of it, let's go. I really, 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 really like this one. Then you pair that with the electricity as well. Oh my gosh. All right, we've been grinding for a while, but hopefully my skins will equal wins versus boss here. This is, look at my skin, let's go. But basically, I love the fluid controls. Oh my gosh, so get out of here, fool. Use of my main abilities. But the cool thing about it is, like, just look at the graphic. It's so good for mobile, but still, you can play this game on iOS. Oh my gosh, I'm about to die, but so was she. Play it on iOS, Android, and even PC. And your PC friends can play cross-platform with you too. So honestly, that's amazing. And oh my gosh, dude, we're so close to dying there. And if you do play in the open beta on PC with the Battle.net, your progression will not get set when it's fully launched.
Swag.
Then after grinding the main storyline for a while, I figured I should explain my favorite character, the Necromancer, for those of you new to Diablo Immortal. As you can summon, look at that skeletal mage that just goes ham, bone-crushing ability for waves of monster, and then skeletons that you command, just look at it, look at them. Then the super ability, oh my gosh, just check this out. Bam, 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 bam. Destroys everything, and that's not even the best part. See all those corpses on the ground there? When the enemies are there, you can blow them up. Corpse explosion, which is crazy.
That's why I love the Necromancer.
Shortly after, we beat the Blood Rose boss, entered the Forgotten Tower dungeon, and then this happened. Oh my gosh, no. Not being able to use potions is a huge nerf. Spin number three. Oh my gosh, to beat this dungeon using only one ability? I already died while I had all of them. Okay, the ability I'm gonna go with is summoning my skeletal mage because he's OP. That's the only ability I can use. I am glad we picked the skeletal mages as they were so OP here.
Dude, honestly, I don't even know if this is possible. Look how OP my mages are. Get going. Destroy them all. Thank you. I can only run around use my auto attack and my mage. Oh my gosh.
It seems to be working. Okay. What also might help too is, like, if you guys did not know, you can actually use controllers to play in this game. It has controller support, which is epic. Maybe I didn't need that. I don't know. These skeleton mages are holding it down. See, we actually didn't die from the skeleton mages, but we're not done with the dungeon. Oh, dude, we just leveled up. That's actually gonna help a lot, only being able to use one ability.
Dude, we have a boss fight with only skeletal mages.
Dude, look at all these chests. Look at all these chests here. Forbidding that. And that was with one ability, bro.
Fortunately, my inventory is full, so we gotta destroy some of this stuff. Get out of here.
And there we go. We beat that dungeon with only one ability. But then we started a legendary whiff, which was super hard. And this was a struggle.
Dude, I'm literally getting trapped here. Are you kidding me? Why is this so scary here? I mean, I know we're in a legendary rift, but come on. Get away from me, dude. Oh my god. Guys, I'm pretty sure this is inevitable. I'm trying to play passive with my skeletal mages. Dude, I don't think there's anything I can do. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. There's been no health orbs that have dropped. Death number four, bro. What is death number four gonna give us on the wheel here? Switch to a new character and start over. That makes us vulnerable to death. Oh no. Our options are the swaggy barbarian, wizard, the demon hunter, or crusader, because we're already necromancer. Let's go with the barbarian. This is good. It's forcing me to pick a new character because I'm training for the tribe videos and I need to win those. So we're basically grinding the tutorial again, which is honestly fine. Because since the game got 35 million pre-registered downloads, that doesn't tell you how good this game is. I don't know what will. All players earn the gilded Horadrim just for completing the tutorial.
Swag.
At least I get to learn new abilities. Cleave multiple enemies 3 times. Dude, that's pretty good.
Boom.
I love this bounce ability. Bam! Dropping the hammer on them fools. Then for absolutely no reason whatsoever, I decided to do this. This is just because I'm crazy and I want to spin again.
This is kind of fun.
Can I die in the tutorial? We're getting there. You can. Okay. It's for entertainment, okay? And because I want to get the donation ones. Like, perfect timing. $500 to Feeding America. Thank you for your gift. Your gift today will help us provide 5,000 meals. Well, that wasn't so painful. That actually felt pretty good. After that, we grinded the tutorial and I remembered how awesome and free-to-play friendly Diablo Immortal is. So whether you're free-to-play or a dirty gemmer like me, everyone is able to play the entire storyline, use all the character classes, all the dungeons, etc. for free, which is epic. So for sure, be sure to try out this game using my link in the description down below. I promise you, it's awesome. But whether you want to spend money or be free to play, it doesn't matter. Not being able to use potions got me once again. Dude, not being able to use potions is literally the biggest nerf. Give me this health. Oh my gosh. This is the bad part about being a tank and not being able to use potions. Oh my gosh. Thank goodness. But we're stunned. Dude, are you kidding me, man? Oh, that one hurts. Didn't save me there. And we're gonna need to spin 2 more times. Actually, spin number one. Use the worst gear I have. That is actually probably gonna make me die again. Basically, you can see everything else is a better option than what I have. Having to use the bad gear for the rest of this actually hurts us a ton. And we are getting an editor bonus. We really love you, so you're actually gonna double this because you're amazing. Edit to the counter, and here's the proof right here. Since there's only 4 left, I'm just gonna spin again and see what happens. Hell grind no. To the next level, only auto attacking, and I have bad gear. And I'm still facing the Skeleton King right now. After all of those spins, we had a ton of nerfs to us. I have no potions. I have the worst gear. I can only auto attack. Bright news, I do get lifesteal still. Bad news, it is so hard to kill everything. Dude, oh my gosh. There's literally no way. All right, spinning again. We get a random name change. Oh, great. Okay. Ute Danka. Mariana Victoria. Just Gaste, I like. What the heck? Rustungus Contaminationen. Okay. And Sequence. One of my favorite games. For my new name. Mariana Victoria. That is my new name. Hello. Nice to meet you. Change name. All right. Change name. It's going to cost me. Gone. Success. Hello. Nice to meet you. All right. So now we have a big task ahead of us. Trying to level up with my worst equipment and I can only auto attack. This is going to be a grind. Now, this was incredibly hard, but after a few near death experiences and a few teleports to safe areas to heal, we were finally close to leveling up. All right, guys, we are so close. We just got to destroy the festering one here. Come on. I think after we destroy this altar and destroy these dudes that were there, this has been probably the hardest thing so far. The grindiest for sure. All right, that's 1. That's 2. Get back here, man.
That's three, level 15. Let's go.
But we're going to wrap it there. Huge thank you to Diablo Immortal for sponsoring this video. Be sure to check it out. Support me. Support the game using the link in the description down below. I highly recommend it. It's awesome. Go check it out. I love you.